also be built from by people from our soil. Can it or can't it? If you don't dream big, then nobody will. Anyway, I think I have bored you a lot, haven't I?
No.
Last point. Never be afraid. Never be afraid. In 2002, yesterday I was doing a program. And in this program, it was about Gujarat. It was about Gotra. Narendra Modi has gone to Gotra and he's done a Sadhvar Nayak. He has stopped other people from going there. There's a big political fight. You know, in life, your own experiences come back to you. I remember coming out of Narendra Modi's house after interviewing him in the height of the riots in 2002. And we came out 50 meters from his residence. We are stopped. Suddenly, our ambassador car is stopped and there are people who are breaking the windows with whistles. They are breaking the windows. All the windows are broken. It's almost as if there are trishuls all around, and I know this is very unsavory, but I must share with you the reality of life as I have seen it. When that happens, we are all told to reveal our religion. It's 50 meters from the chief minister's house. How it happened, I don't know. We said we are journalists. No, no, what is your religion? What is your religion? And thankfully, let me tell you, there was nobody from a minority community with us, but one of our people. We had our identity cards, press cards. My driver did not have a press card. And I looked at, I was sitting in the front. I have an obsession with sitting in the front seat. I looked to my right, and I can see the look on my driver's face. When people talk about secularism, I have seen hate from up close. And I know that group of people who have killed him. He had a tattoo, you know, he put a hair arm or something on his, like, it's not a tattoo, it's actually just an imprint that you put, which stays with you. He showed that and we walked out. But I saw for that moment how scared he was. And that is an image which stays to me today. Today, when people threaten me, when people advise me, there are some politicians who call me and say, you have a young family, why do you want to lose your job? You have a career, why do you want to lose it? Why do you want to report on scams? When they do all that, the image of that driver comes back in my mind. And I tell myself, I will never be afraid. What is the most that they can do? What is the most that they can do? If you are honest and hardworking, and if you are ambitious, then trust me, nobody beyond the point of time can touch you. Do you believe in that or not? Therefore, do not be afraid. And not just be afraid in that sense, do not, and this is my last and very important point to you, do not be afraid of taking a risk in life. Take the risks in life. If you don't take a risk, you will not grow. Take it from me, guaranteed. Gone are the days when you get a job and you stay for 20 years, 40 years. I'm not telling you to change 10 jobs in the first 5 years. But if I had not left NDTV, why should I have left NDTV? I was doing fine. I had a very good salary. I had bought a house in Gurgaon, my son was going to the best school. I was 30 years old. I was doing fine. Why did I still don't know why I left NDTV. I suddenly landed up and I landed up in Delhi. And from Delhi to Bombay, I changed everything. I was in a room. A piece of paper was given to me and they said, go start a channel. And I had nothing to do. I was told.